welcome back to my channel. It is Nurse Michelle here. So if you are new to my channel, I would like to introduce myself. So hey, my name is Michelle. I am a registered nurse, a critical care registered nurse. I have been doing nursing for 2 full years now and some change. So I know a little something about something. My background is in critical care, like I mentioned, in the ICU, and I also have experience working in the PACU as well. If you're watching this, you're probably interested in nursing as a career, or you know somebody who's thinking about nursing as a career, or you are in nursing school and you just want to confirm that, you know, you possess these characteristics that I'm going to be mentioning, or you are a nurse already and you just want to watch this video, or you just like me and you just want to watch my videos. I appreciate all of it, but this is a very informative video. There's definitely a need in this profession and I want to encourage more people to join into this career. So if this is you, then nursing is for you. Let's get started. First and foremost, in order to be a nurse, you need to be a decent human being. You have to be a good human being with a caring heart, a heart that loves people. If this is not you, then you're not going to sustain in this profession. Nursing is such a selfless profession. I'm saying this because as a nurse, you are responsible for another human being. You're responsible for caring for the other human being. And, you know, the population that we're taking care of are very vulnerable, especially in the ICU. You are the patient's advocate. You're going to be making, you know, you're going to be doing things for the patients that, you know, if they were able, they would have been doing for themselves. But because they are in the state that they're in, you are going to be the hands of the patients, the mind of the patient. If you're the type of person who doesn't get, you know, squeamish over blood, or if the type of person in where bodily secretions don't, you know, freak you out, don't gross you out as much as other people, then this profession is for you. As nurses, you are going to be coming in contact with a lot of bodily fluids, so just mentally prepare yourself for that. You're going to be, you know, touching it, you're going to be discarding it, you're going to be protecting people from it. So just put in your mind that, you know, this is the reality of the job. If you love science, then nursing is for you. If you don't love science and you want to be a nurse, then begin to like science, because this is like a major part of the curriculum in nursing school. Even before getting into the program, you're going to take classes like biology, microbiology, anatomy and physiology, other sciences, sometimes chemistry. So you're going to have a strong suit in science. And once you get into the program, you're going to be taking classes like pathophysiology, in which really breaks down the disease processes, so that you have a better understanding of the people that you're going to be taking care of. You're going to be taking classes like pharmacology, in which it breaks down the medications and the pathways that, not that in depth, but it goes into the type of medications that your patients will be receiving. You're going to have to be knowledgeable about the things you're doing. So, you know, a chunk of nursing is science. So you're going to have to be really good in science. Like I said, if science is not your strong suit, make it your strong suit. Find tutors. Do everything in your power to ace these classes, because having the fundamental understanding will be very beneficial for you in your career in the future. If you are a disciplined individual, then nursing is for you. Nursing requires a lot of self-discipline. And I'm saying this because, you know, with nursing school, there are strict rules. There are strict attendance policies that you need to follow. You're going to have to show up in order to learn. And, you know, this all requires having good self-discipline, you know, having good time management skills. If this is you, then nursing is for you. Knowing when to wake up, setting your alarm. There are going to be moments where you're going to be waking up before the sun come up just to make it to clinical. These are sacrifices you need to think about. So you're going to have to become a morning person. If you're not already, become a morning person. But if you're already a morning person, then, you know, this career is for you. You have to respect authority. Like I said before, there's just a lot of rules that you need to follow, you know, especially with clinical, the type of uniform you're going to be wearing, the type of shoes you're going to be wearing, how to maintain your nails, you know, the type of earrings you're allowed to wear and not wear. You know, there's just little rules like that that you're going to have to follow. If you're the type of person who loves flexibility, then nursing is the perfect career for you. In terms of the time you get to work, there are so many different shifts you can work in this field. If you're not a 9-to-5 type of person, then nursing is for you. In other terms of flexibility, with patient population, nursing is not stagnant. You're not stuck taking care or looking at one particular thing. If you love kids, you can become a pediatric nurse. If you love old people, you know, there's gerontology that you can get into. If you want to focus on just wound care, you can do that. If you want to focus on you know, just hearts, you can become a cardiac nurse. If you want to focus on surgeries, there are surgical nurses. My background is in surgery trauma, so I'm a surgical trauma ICU nurse. So there's just a vast amount of avenues in the field of nursing that you can, you know, maneuver through. And the thing is, you're not, if you choose one thing, you're not stuck there. You could always move from one place to another within the field of nursing. I knew a nurse who was a surgery trauma nurse. She did that for a couple of years. She started getting tired of it. She switched from being a surgery trauma nurse to a labor and delivery nurse. So, I mean, you see how different the fields are, but it's all within one career, which is just phenomenal. So you have a lot of options. So if you're the type of person that likes change, nursing is for you. And another thing with nursing, if you have hopes into getting a graduate degree, nursing is for you. There are plenty of graduate degrees that you can get within the field of nursing. You can, you know, go to school to become a nurse anesthetist, a nurse practitioner, and become a clinical nurse specialist, go to grad school for education, management. You can do any of that. If you want a sustainable career with job security, nursing is for you. You will never have to look for a job for too long because there are places that are always hiring. That's one privilege of having a degree in nursing. You will always find a job. Always. 99.9%. There's just an abundance of jobs for nurses that you can find. A whole plethora of them. So job security is guaranteed. Last thing I want to add on is that, you know, with anything you do, it requires a lot of dedication. It requires a lot of self-discipline. It requires a lot of grit. Nursing school is hard. Just, it is what it is. But if you apply yourself, you can make it. Do everything in your power to pass your classes and you can make it. So I just want to leave you guys with that. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and leave me a comment. Let me know what your thoughts were on this video. If you have any add-ons, let me know, you know, if this is you, like, what are other characteristics that you think nurses possess that other people who are interested in the field should know about? Leave it in the comments below. Once again, do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Subscribe, because there's more good content coming, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.